In some of our previous videos, we've touched briefly on the consequences of the COVID-19 pandemic on job loss, food and housing insecurity, and student life. Due to the economic shock of all-around closures and slowed rates of commerce, these consequences have come to affect us all in one way or another in the past year. For the next few weeks, we're going to elaborate on the extent of COVID's non-medical impacts and what this might mean for our future. Since April 2020, there has been evidence of a sharp increase in hardship across the board, with tens of millions of people either on significantly reduced income or out of work completely. More families are struggling to afford food or rent, and this continues today. Even though some jobs have been recovered and many Americans have received some stimulus payments, an estimated 1 in 6 adult renters, 12 million people, are still behind on rent. Families with children were most likely to struggle to make rent and to get food on the table. Out of every 10 children living in rental housing, 4 are in homes that are either behind on rent or where there isn't enough to eat. Renters of color, already vulnerable to housing discrimination in countless ways, have also been more likely to be unable to make rent during the pandemic, in many cases because people of color have borne a disproportionate percentage of the job losses during the pandemic. Many localities and the federal government implemented eviction moratoriums, meaning that even if people couldn't pay rent, they couldn't be evicted for non-payment while the moratorium was in place. But renters will still owe that rent when the moratorium is lifted. So if they were out of work during that time and won't be able to make up that back rent, a temporary moratorium will just postpone those evictions. These moratoriums also haven't stopped landlords from pursuing evictions for reasons other than non-payment of rent, which haven't always been covered by the existing state and federal moratoriums. You might be saying to yourself, well, the pandemic isn't landlords' fault. Why should they have to lose income? And they shouldn't. If huge numbers of people cannot work and cannot pay rent, landlords, including lots of mom-and-pop landlords who are depending on those rent checks, won't have an income either. The only sustainable way to handle loss of income, both for landlords and their tenants, is widespread, generous financial assistance. If people have lost their jobs, they need that income replaced so they can stay in their homes and so their landlords don't lose their income either. The stimulus payments people have received aren't nothing, and they've been life-saving for some. But for people who've been out of work for long periods of time and are facing eviction when moratoriums are lifted, assistance is needed. If we kick everything to the eviction courts, we risk millions of people losing their homes and millions more losing the rental income they depend on. Homeowners are also feeling the pinch. In addition to the 12 million people behind on rent, another 11 million people live in homes where they're behind on their mortgage payments. There has been a federal moratorium on foreclosures and forbearance for mortgage payments, policies that were both recently extended through June 2021. But it's likely we will still see a wave of foreclosures when this assistance expires, affecting an estimated 225,000 to 500,000 homes. Keeping people in their homes is important for so many reasons, but one is that it's critical for public health. Eviction leads to a downward spiral of health and well-being outcomes. Eviction is associated with increased reliance on emergency room visits, chronic diseases, mental health issues, substance use, and suicide. Children are especially vulnerable to these risks. Families with children are more likely to be evicted, and when children experience eviction, the effects can reverberate through their lifetime. Respiratory illness is also particularly dangerous for people without homes. Congregate shelters tend to be close quarters, leaving people vulnerable to contagious diseases, and living outdoors can make social distancing and hygiene extremely difficult. For all these reasons, it's critical to keep as many people as possible from losing their homes, and for making sure that unhoused people receive targeted aid to get them safely sheltered and to get them any other assistance they need to be safe and healthy. One thing pandemics are good at is proving that there's no protecting any of us unless we're protecting everyone.